and it's done. Now if you refresh it again, you will see attachments, OneDrive, OneNote and Outlook.
Hey everybody, welcome to this new video. And today we have with ourselves Ronak Parmar. He is a security researcher at Altered Security and also OSWE. Hey Ronak.
Hey Ketan, what's up?
All good. So what are we going to study today?
But today we are going to do something different, which is never done in your channel. We are going to see about red teaming and doing some phishing attacks, where we are going to see how is it possible to abuse app registration of feature in Azure portal to get some consent, which is like getting permissions from our victims. So I have for that, I'm going to introduce you my tool, which is the 365 Stealer. So we are going to see how to set up this tool and how we can use it to phish any victims who has access to his Office 365 license, and how we can leverage it to get even reverse shell as well.
Okay, that's awesome. Let's begin.
Okay, so first, let me tell you what is illicit consent grant attack. So basically, you have might be seeing like whenever we go any in browser, like we get an option like sign in via Google or sign in via Microsoft. So every time we have an option to click like accept this permission and all those stuff. So basically, these apps only ask us for accessing our permissions like profile or email ID. That's it. But what if these applications ask more privileges like reading files or reading emails as well? So that's what we are going to do. We are going to create a phishing page where there will be a button from where if a user click it, so he will get an option to give his permission, like read all files and mails or create Outlook rules and all those stuff. So basically in real world, many people don't even read those permissions and they blindly just click on accept, where they don't even know what permissions are they accepting for. So for that, basically we are going to need a developer account in Azure portal. Then we can just navigate to Azure Active Directory. And from here, we can click app registrations. Let me show you. Azure portal is bit slow as compared to others like AWS. So we can click on app registrations here and click on new registration. So basically this will create a identity platform for us from which we can get some access tokens of our victims. So for now we'll keep its name like test. And make sure to click multi-tenant to while you are phishing someone who is on another tenant, like another company in simple words. And then you have to give your redirect URL. So this will be the URL on which you are going to get your victim's access token. So for now, I'll keep it HTTPS, my keyboard, localhost. It's just for testing right now. And make sure to have login / authorize. And this endpoint is only for only while using my tool, like this 365 Stealer. So we click register here. So right now we have an app registration created. Now we'll quickly just take go to my tool, which you can get it from GitHub, Altered Security. And here it is 365 Stealer. And you can download it. And you will be needed two things. One, your XAMPP server, and another will be the Python 3. So you can just go navigate to XAMPP, htdocs, and paste your files in this folder. Just extract here. I'll just make it. So, and you can just start your XAMPP server. Start. And one more thing, if you have to do some minor changes in your victim / index.php, you just need to change the path of your Python 3. Like if your command for Python 3 is Python 3, then you will keep it Python 3 or just give it Python. Or you can even give your full path of your Python exe as well. And if there is any need that you want to change your database location, or if there is another location for your to for the PY file, you can mention it here as well. So let's navigate to our local host. So it will look like something this. So this is the portal management for 365 Stiller, and to manage all your victims. So from here, you can click on 365 configurations, and you can see like you have to provide client ID, client secret, and some other stuff. So we already have a client ID, which is application ID. We'll copy it here and place it here. We'll have to create a secrets, which is a certificates and secrets, and create a secret. So this is basically a password kind of thing for your app registration. So you can even log in using this secret value as well. The redirect URL, you can get it from overview tab, click on redirect URIs and copy this value, paste it here. This will be the value when the victim's data has been stolen. You can redirect the user to some another website, or you can just give it a slash. So it will just redirect him to your phishing page homepage. Then this will be the path of your macros TXE. So it will be like the macro value which you want to inject in your victim's OneDrive DOCX file. So basically it will look like, show you how does it look like. It will be look like this. So basically this is the macros where I'm trying to execute a command from which I'm trying to get a reverse shell from victim's system. So right now there's no need to get a reverse shell here. And this will be the extensions that you are interested in. So for now, we can give a wildcard, like you want all the files. And this is the delay, like how much delay you want to create while stealing the data. Because if you are creating lots of graph API requests, there might be possible that there will be some detection to, and it will create an alert for the admin, like someone is creating lots of requests. We'll just skip it 1 second and click on save. So if you can just refresh the page, we can see that it's all set. You can click on run 365 Stiller. You can just take this phishing link from directly from here, or you can just go to its homepage, which is https localhost, which will look like this. Or you can just, so like this will be the phishing page which you are going to send to your victim. And he will be like advertising certificate study guide, and he will click on read more, and he will be redirected to the endpoint where he have to log in using this. So currently, as you can see, it's asking a permission, which is like sign you in and read your profile. So this is the basic permission which all the application asks, but as being an attacker, we are obviously not interested in such kind of permissions. We will go for more. So for that permissions, we can go to API permissions, and we can select all the permissions which we are interested in. So you can see it's only asking for user.read. We can click here, add a permission, then click on Microsoft Graph and click on delegated permissions. And from here, we can give all the permission that we want from the victim. So for now, we'll go first one by one. First, we are interested in reading all the mails. So we'll go mail dot read and write. We are also interested in writing the mails. This. Then we are also interested in sending mails. So we'll click on mails dot read as well. Then we are also interested in creating Outlook rules. So we will go mail box settings, which is this, and click on read write. Then we are interested in reading all the files, like OneDrive files. So we'll click on, write file. And we can click on files, read, write, all. Then we want access to OneNote as well. So we'll click type notes. For now, we are just interested in reading the notes because there might be any credentials available in their notes. We'll click on read, write, all.
Ranak, right now we are setting up our that auth permissions that we will be taking as an attacker, right?
Exactly. So whenever he clicks that button, so this application is going to ask more permissions rather than just asking that one profile like this for permission. So it will be
Okay,
less
okay.
too many. So for now, I'm just showing you all the permissions that you can do. But in real life, we have to do only one or two, because if a victim sees so many of permissions, there he might be feel something if something is like wrong.
Yeah,
Can
okay.
click on add permissions. So all the permissions have been added. And also one thing I just forgot it. What if you want to know how many users are available in your victim's company? So we can type user dot, and it's I think it's users. It's no harm. We can go right here, user read basic all this one. So this will allow us to read all the users available in the in the victim's tenant. Okay, so we have set all the permissions. We can just try to click again here. It might take few seconds or minute as well. It done. So now you can see it's asking so many of permissions. So as per being a dumb user, I will obviously click on this accept button because it looks so beautiful, right?
Yeah, everyone is always in hurry.
That's yes,
And
I
they don't check what's they are giving permission for.
Absolutely. So they have been like redirect to here, but also as you have seen in the configuration, I have given up an option to redirect the user some another domain as well. So now if you will refresh this thing, you will get the use victim here, and you have all the files that you are interested in actually. Like you can upload a file like this. So this file will be uploaded in your victims.
Oh,
Right.
in victims OneDrive.
Yes. So if you see, let me show you how does it actually looks like in, yeah, it is. So this was the token. Let me show you. So this was the authorization code. It's working. Let me wait. It's
Okay.
this. You can see the OneDrive files are coming. Attachments has been three attachments has been downloaded. You can see credentials.txt.
So it's getting all the files from OneDrive, from
Yes.
victims OneDrive.
Yes. One. So all the files that a user has access to, it will download all those things. So now it's going for OneNote. And it's done. Now, if you can refresh it again, you will see attachments, OneDrive, OneNote, and Outlook. Outlook looks like this. So it's just a file like created if anyone wants to share this thing. OneNote, it's here. You can click on view. So it's look like this. Then OneDrive. So these are all the files that victim has. So we can click on, it's not visible. Can't be viewed. Read me. It's here it is. And attachments, you can see three attachments are available. Now, if you want to list all the users, like in the victim's tenant, so we can click list user directly and it will give me all the users available. You can just filter out like this display name or email ID or their object ID. So this is the object ID basically. And you can even click on export. So it will export your list of files, the list of users. Then we can also click on search button to list all the emails, like absolutely all the emails that a victim has.
Oh,
Directly just,
that's awesome.
yeah, so we can directly just click, say password. Like I want the mails which contains this word. So I'll click search. And now if you see password, so it will show me only mails which containing this word. And see, so this way you can just filter out as per your need, like subject contains or sender email, like from whom is being sent, or you can click on has attachments. So it will only display the mails which contains these attachments, and you can just click on re here and it will download the file. It's as simple as that.
Okay,
Now you have
that's
some,
awesome.
so here you have some action tabs from which you can send a mail from victim's email to someone else. So suppose like this, this, and you can even, it's up to you if you want to give the attachment or not. And it will send mail. So mail sent. I have already shown you a way of uploading a file, and here it will create an Outlook rules. So what it does, like if any mails arrive to victim and if that mail contains a word password, so that email will automatically will be sent to this domain and this email ID basically. So you can just change that, like my email ID, like something like gmail.com. So if a victim gets a mail which contains a keyword like password, you can see body contains password. So that mail, that whole mail will be forwarded to trouble1@gmail.com.
Okay. Means so we can create some sets of rule that will automatically make the mail transfer to this address, right? Which contains password.
Exactly. It's something like a backdoor, you can say.
Okay.
So yeah, after then, like you can upload your malware, that whatever you want to upload, like a doc file containing macros, and whenever that victim downloads it, then you will get that reverse shell.
Okay, that's awesome, man. That's awesome. Yes.
So suppose if you have too many of victims, like 10, 20, 100 of victims, and you want to refresh their, so suppose like after 10, 20 days, you want to again check, like what if the victim has any new files. So basically you can do two things. One, you can refresh all, you can again steal all the users' data, or you can steal any particular user's data. So for example, suppose if I delete this OneDrive, let me just delete this. Suppose I have deleted this OneDrive, and if I click here, refresh all users' data, so it will keep on stealing again, like it will steal all the this victim's data again. Show you, it will take a time. You can just click on refresh.
So if we, even if we delete some user, it will pull back again.
Yes, that user. So it's like after even after 2 months, if you want to try again to steal data, you can just basically, without phishing a user, you can steal his data.
Okay,
so you can see OneDrive is again back. So even if this access token is basically alive for 1 hour. And so if you want a new access token, so suppose we just delete this access token and I want a new access token, I will just click on get new token and it will create a new token for me. And if you want to use this token for your own self, like using manual stuff, creating your own API calls, so you can use that as well. You can use app. These are some configurations done. So all those things I've shown you is from portal, but you can actually do all these things from command line as well, like everything. Let me show you how it's done. I'll just shut this down first. I'll go to HT docs, my CMD, and we can say Python 365 -- help. So what I'm doing, acha. So these are all the options that you get. Like you can set configurations, you can get all configurations, you can even customize your own phishing page from which you can pass your arguments like code, refresh token, which you have seen. Let me show you what I actually mean. Let me fish this user one again. Need to enable. Run. Reload. So here you can see whenever a user is phished, Microsoft sends us some details like this auth code. As you can see, this parameter.
Yeah.
So this is the authorization code, which is basically alive for only 10 minutes. So suppose if you want to create your own phishing page and you want to pass an arguments, like once you get this token, this code, you can pass an argument from here where you can provide this code, then your client ID, your this client ID, client secret, and you can perform this. You can use this tool in your own personal way as well. So let me show you how it's done. Like if you want to set any config, So here you can just provide your client ID. For now, I'm just giving it randomly anything. This. So it's done. And whatever permissions that you do from here will be done at this place as well. Let me show you. 365 your victims. So you see?
Yeah.
Both are the same, but for now I just want to keep it back. And save. So this was actually cached, so I use that only. So that's it for this video. I think this is a complete guide for using 365 Stealer. Later on, you can explore these options by yourself. It's not so super difficult or complex. It's just straightforward.
So, Ronak, if we want to protect ourselves from this kind of attack, so what can we do? Like, we need to check the permissions when we are giving some auth permission to an application.
Let me show you. So basically, whenever we go to portal, like going to Azure Active Directory, we have an option. Like if you go to enterprise application and we'll see like this consent and permissions. This is basically one responsible for all those things. So you can see allow user consent for apps. So this option allows our user to give permissions to any third party site. So basically an admin just have what he wants to do. He should do not allow user consent, click on this so that absolute no user will be able to give their permission. Let me show you this. So now I have selected this but I think I am myself an admin, so I might be able to give permission. Let me just check. But if another user like my user is trying to give his consent, his permissions to a third party site, so he won't be able to do that.
Okay. So administrator need to check that permission so that other users don't give permission to any unusual apps.
Right. So you can see an administrator will be required for all apps. So do not allow user consent. So no one will be able to give their consent. If they want to, then they have to contact their admin and ask them to allow them to give the consent to the third party site. Or if the organization wants to provide any consent if the internal website, like internal apps as well. So they have to, so it's better to choose this option, which is like where your app will be registered by a Microsoft. So if you see, if I click here, you will get an unverified kind of thing. Like this app is actually not verified. Basically I'm logged in. Just a minute. I need to log in using another user. Okay, just a second. I'll just log out this. Because right now I'm already logged in, so it's not asking. And I've also given my permissions. So it's not asking me again to give permissions. So if you see here, read more, and automatically it will give that code. You see?
Yeah. So
not asking anymore again. So I'll need get log out first. Maybe I need to actually create a new app for that.
No issue. Okay, Ronak, like nowadays we see lots of apps are taking OAuth permissions from like Google Drive and all those. So do you think like this might be also vulnerable in other, this might work?
It's not vulnerable. It's like misconfiguration, or you can say not even misconfiguration. It's like abusing the feature. So suppose you have a feature, you're using it in the right way, but attackers are using it in a wrong way and tricking the end user, like victims. So it's not any vulnerability or kind of thing. It's just the abusing and a feature.
Okay, so it's like social engineering attack. We need to leverage it using social engineering.
Exactly. Okay. So that's it. So this is like mitigation for this attack. If you click here, so no user will be able to provide any their consent. And one more thing. After the 9th November, there was a changes done by the Microsoft. What was the thing like? As you can see, this is the tenant. This is one tenant that I have access to. This one. there will be now another tenant, like victim's tenant. And now if I try to access any permissions, like files and all those stuffs, I won't be able to actually get those permissions. Even if the setting is done to allow all consent, they won't be able to do, because Microsoft knows this kind of attack. So they have prevented this kind of attack. So only permissions that they can provide is like they can actually, then an attacker get from another tenant, like multi-tenant, is the user read or calendars read or task read, like very low privileged permissions. So if you want to use this tool for your initial access, you can use this for getting permissions like this, like user read or get reading their tasks or their calendars. And if suppose you have already phished your user by doing something else and you're already in their own tenant, so you will be able to actually use their own tenants applications to phish the tenants users as well. So I hope you understood it.
Yeah. Okay. Got it.
Kind of tricky, but you have to like do it practically only, then you will understand it. So yeah, this is basically being used in Pentest Academy's bootcamp, which is attacking and defending Azure AD Cloud, which is used to phish a user to get their access to OneDrive and then try to like get a reverse shell accessing his systems and like then doing some lateral movements and privilege escalations and all those stuff. And also you can read out
this finding has been added to Pentester course for Azure.
Yes.
That's awesome, man.
Thank you. So you can go to with this blog as well. I have tried to explain it in a very detailed way and how to use it as well. So you can find out all the ways like how to use this tool in a fully way.
Okay, that's awesome. So Radhak, thank you for sharing this information with us. Guys, I will share the link to the blog and course in the description. So, Ronak, before we close, do you want to say anything to the audience?
Yes, I would like to say one thing. See, about OSWE or any certifications. See, don't stuck and don't keep on studying basics and basics, because see, basic will be something which never be end. If you're stuck on reading out basics and trying to get any reference and all those stuff, just stop that. Directly jump into the course and start doing it. Even if you're doing OSCP, OSWE or OSEE, and even if you see all those prerequisites that it's asking, like you should know this knowledge or this knowledge, that really doesn't matter at all. You should actually just jump into the course and start studying. Don't waste a lot of time into learning basics, because it will actually never end. So like even if you ask me, I took OSWE with zero knowledge in a web application, and today I'm OSWE. So don't get afraid, just jump into it.
that's very true. So thank you Ronak for being with us, and bye-bye.
Yeah, thank you. Bye. Have a good day.
Thank you guys for watching. If you want, then you can subscribe now or afterwards, no hurry. And also many hackers are going to come on this channel in the future. So until next time, see ya.